Hello. We welcome you to yet another exciting edition of your favorite online TV program, Youth Weekly or UTV Africa, a program that brings you news that made the headlines within the week in the language and the perspective of youth. My name is Makinde Tinola.
And my name is Ayomekwasi Ayodele. Here are some of the news that made the headlines within the week. Dogara sacks Appropriation Committee Chairman over budget padding.
FG approves green alternative policy towards diversified economy.
Women protesters storm National Assembly for Tinubu.
Firm to sack drivers who test positive for alcohol.
And on sports, Keshi to be buried in Ila, July 29.
And on the international scene, Russian firm to construct refinery in Calabar.
Turkey imposed 3 months state of emergency to catch coup plotters. These are some of the news that made the headlines within the week. Join us shortly as we get down to discuss some of these issues. Don't go away.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, this is Still Youth Weekly on UTV Africa. And this is our discussion segment where we take on some of the boiling issues within the week. Firm to sack drivers who test positive to alcohol. As part of his effort to reduce accidents on the roads, Peace Mass Transit Limited, this road transport, they've put it upon themselves to like vow to sack any driver who is alcohol tested, probably after the accident and they went to rescue or something. They are going to check for, okay, what really is the cause? You know, that's what they do. Either the tire busts or something. But if they see that the cause of it has been rampant to be alcohol-stricken drivers, driving a couple of people and causing them to die unnecessarily, they have put it upon themselves to like go for tests for drivers, which I think is okay to start with.
You know,
but I'm wondering how they want to go about the strategy on trying to test for alcohol.
There's always a way to test. In China, there was a time when they test everybody driving if you're having certain degrees of alcohol, and you go to prison for it.
Okay, so are you saying that before they start to drive, they bring drivers to a particular place to test for alcohol?
They can actually test at different points. They can test before the driver drives. They can also test along the way. They have depots along the way.
Yeah.
So they can do those testing, but it's not mandatory because there's no how you can actually take alcohol and it drains out of the blood in a short while. You get my point. So you can do the testing in whatever way you intend to do it. I think medical people will be there to give them the best advice on that.
I'm just wondering how that strategy is going to go by. Only probably if they're going to make it look like, or make it seem like it's only the people that travel cross-country. You know, those are the people that carry loads of people across borders. Maybe before they set on their journey, they're going to go for tests, and one of it is alcohol test. That still makes sense.
To the women protesters storming National Assembly for Tinubu's wife, that was kind of verbally abused. By assaulted.
Mention all the names.
So they stormed to say Malai has to apologize for the way he said things he said to her. That a senator is a senator, be it a woman or a man. In fact, I like one of their lines. They actually said a senator is a senator. Women are not threat objects. So they went on with different placards and different demonstrations saying that, and it was kind of, yes, these people are standing up to say so.
I think that's a call to awareness of gender equality, making us see reasons why there are some things that women will not naturally be allowed to do. Why? Because they are just women. Like in the case of being a senatorial candidate now, we are both senators and I have every right to view or air my opinion.
Yes.
And because I'm trying to air my opinion, probably against yours, you are now verbally assaulting me. I mean, that is enough for you to see that gender inequality is being practiced even in the places where it's supposed to be ruled.
It's supposed to be. I think there should be a practical action against this so that male senators and we'll be glad if you become part of this conversation. Send in your tweets, send us a comment via Facebook. But we'll be going on a short break. We'll be back shortly.
Youth Weekly, Youthanize and News.
We are part of the solution.
We bring you youth perspective on issues. Youths have a voice.
We have a story to tell.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, this is still Youth Weekly, and we are in our discussion segment. Before we went on break, we were talking about firms checking their drivers if they are drunk before driving or while driving. And we also discussed about women protesting at the National Assembly for Tinubu on the issues as senators who are verbally abusing each other. And I think we'll move on from that point to talk about Turkey's president imposing 3-month state of emergency on the whole nation, not even a section. And his target is to catch coup plotters. It's kind of focused. They don't want to take chances. It's not like Boko Haram bombs Bauchi or Adamawa, and then we declare state of emergency on Adamawa. But he said, okay, since this was a coup, we're going to keep the nation on a standstill for 3 months to whistle out anywhere where the coup plotters are.
Yes. I'm going to come from the angle of how the state of the economy will be if there will be no activity productive to the economy. A 3-month state of emergency is like a curfew, no activity. Is that what it is? Just to get you right.
It's a curfew, but it's not totally cramping down the economy.
So he's saying that people, civil servants are going to work, bankers are going to go to work.
People are going to be doing their work.
So what's state of emergency?
The state of emergency is that our focus for these 3 months is going to be on security, and security is going to be on dealing with coup plotters. As long as you are an African, it is your responsibility to keep the peace, unity, and security of Africa, no matter the country you come from. This is as much as we can take today. For further information and inquiry, follow us on our social media platforms, as seen on your screen. Have a nice weekend. Bye.